Hello and welcome back, you guys, to Dang Que Rico. As you can tell by my very festive attire, we are celebrating St. Patrick's. And to celebrate St. Patrick's, I am going to do a shepherd's pie. In a little minute, I'm going to be showing you guys all the ingredients needed for shepherd's pie. So, until then.
Okay, y'all, so these are all the ingredients we're going to be using for shepherd's pie. I'm essentially doing a cottage pie. The reason they call it a cottage pie is because it's done with meat or turkey versus lamb or mutton, which is usually what they use for shepherd's pie. We're using turkey. I already seasoned the turkey with some garlic salt and some pepper. To do the potato on top, I am going to use Fairlife just because I am lactose intolerant, but feel free to use regular milk. We also have some sour cream, some of my fave butter. I have the potatoes here so that they wouldn't brown on me. Just sitting in water, also releasing a little bit of that starch. We have our sofrito base, which is garlic, my strawberry onion, of course, and some peppers. Here we have some green onions and carrots, and I'm using the rest of the matchstick carrots from the previous Chinese rice video. And we have some celery here. We're also going to be using caldo de res, which is technically a little beef stock when you add it with water, of course. We're going to be using 2 bay leaves. I have some Worcestershire sauce. Excuse me if I butchered that. Not really sure how you say it. We've got black pepper, sea salt, and of course we have some red cooking wine. So, ready, set, go!
Alright y'all, I also forgot to tell you that we are adding tomato paste. This is going to be our thickener for the sauce because y'all know that I do not like to make a roux unless I absolutely need to make a roux. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to do our sofrito first and we're going to go from there. Super excited. While we're also doing the sofrito and cooking stuff, we're going to be cooking already the potatoes. Everything should be done at the same time, which is what we're looking for because no one likes to waste time cooking excessively. So we're gonna do it all at once and I'm gonna show you guys how that's done. All right, so over here at the back, y'all can't see it, so I'm just gonna show it to you. We have our potatoes and water and I'm gonna go ahead and start boiling that on high with the lid on. So that's gonna start cooking. And then over here, we're going to start our sofrito. For those of you that don't know what a sofrito is, it's just essentially anything that has peppers, onions, and garlic in it. It's what us Hispanics use to basically do everything. We love it. Also, you guys, I'm going to go ahead and add some olive oil to my potatoes and some sea salt. And yes, as you can see, this is not sponsored by Trader Joe's, but if they want to sponsor me, they totally can because I buy absolutely everything from them. They are the bomb diggity. As always, you guys, I try not to season too much with salt, but that's just me. Everyone has their ways of doing things. That's just mine. If you ask my mom, she will always put more salt in her food. But if you ask my man, he won't. So all right, sorry for all the racket. We got that going. I'm gonna throw a little bit of salt on there and a little bit of pepper. Or a lot of bit of pepper, so I love pepper.
And you guys, I'm just gonna throw some red pepper flakes into this. The recipe doesn't call for it, but I like absolutely everything spicy. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. So we're just gonna let that simmer, and once the onions are a little bit transparent, we're gonna go ahead and add our meat. We're gonna cook that down, and then we're gonna go ahead and do our little sauce. Alright you guys, so now that our onions are a little bit transparent, I'm gonna go ahead and add the carrots and the green onion. I'm just gonna use my hand, y'all. It is what it is. And we're gonna go ahead also and put in the celery. No lie, y'all, it already smells really good. As sofrito usually does. No, it smells delicious. Like, literally, if you don't know how to cook, you want your friends to think you do, just put some garlic and onions on the stove. So we're gonna keep that there. And then, obviously, this shepherd's pie does not call for green onions, but I had some, so I threw them in there because why the hell not? And again, you guys, just like with the tomato paste that I told you guys about later, at the end, literally before putting it in the oven, I'm going to add some frozen peas. I'm not going to add them now. You know, I'll add them literally when the meat is done and we're about to pop it in, because they're frozen, so they don't really need to be cooked down or anything. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and add our meat. Well, turkey. I haven't had shepherd's pie in a minute. Like my boyfriend likes to say. No, like seriously though, I haven't had it in a while. The last time I had it was at my stepmom's house, and she totally forgot that I did not like lamb, and she made it with lamb, and then she's like, like, I'm not gonna say anything, she's not gonna notice. Obviously, I totally noticed, you guys, because that's one thing, I do have a very, like, chef's palate. I'll notice a lot of things that you're gonna put in the food that people don't usually notice, like spices and things. So I did notice, but it was delicious, so I did eat it. Either way. Okay, we're gonna let that cook a little bit. Our potatoes are boiling over here, so I'm gonna take the lid off. And I'm gonna reduce the heat on the potatoes to medium. We're just gonna keep cooking this bad boy down. I will see you guys in a sec to do our little sauce over here. Alright y'all, so again, so this is ready to go. I'm gonna add my red pepper flakes. Again, you don't have to add this. I like my stuff a little spicy. So, yeah. Gonna do that, then we're gonna put our two bay leaves, and now when we put this in the pan with the potatoes on top and all that, we're gonna take these babies out, but for now we're gonna put them in there. You definitely do not want anyone choking on a baby. This is 2 cups of water, because I'm gonna break up my little beef stock in here, and I want to make, as we know, a gravy for this. Let's see if I don't mess this up. Alright, so this is the 1/2 cup of wine. And I'm using red cooking wine, but if you guys want to use regular wine,
You can just, you know, don't use grape juice, y'all. And this is one tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce. And for the sake of measuring it accordingly, this is 1/4 cup of tomato paste. Not sauce. I never said sauce. I said paste. A lot of people will do recipes and they'll be like, oh, I can just use tomato sauce. I mean, like, yeah, if you're in a bind, you have nothing else, so then you're going to have to use the flour to make a roux, to really, like, put this together. And I just like tomato paste so much better than tomato sauce. Right, so here I have my little beef bouillon, and I'm just going to go ahead and break it in. Obviously, we don't have a microwave in our house. No, it's not because there's no space or anything like that. It's legit because just we don't like to use microwave. We literally reheat everything on the stove. We don't want any more radioactive waves that we don't need. So, essentially though, if you do have a microwave, you just grab the 2 cups of water, you put the beef bouillon in, and you microwave it. So much easier. It's already, will be easier for you to incorporate. I'm gonna go ahead and mix this in. You guys, it smells phenomenal. I can't wait to freaking try it. I'm so excited. Alright. So that's there. And now, we're going to cover it. And we're going to let it kind of do its thing. And then after, I have the peas here to add them in a little bit when this gets a little thicker. Alright. Alright, y'all, so once you want it to thicken a little bit, after a while of it simmering, you're going to want to turn it up to high heat. I'm going to go ahead and take out the bay leaves. So the sauce is almost gone, which is good. So I'm going to put in the peas. Cover it again. Just wait for the last of the sauce to dissipate. You don't want it too dry either, so make sure you have something left. And then after we do that, we're gonna go ahead and I'm gonna show you the video of mashing the potatoes and putting everything together. All right, y'all, so here we have a baking dish. And we're gonna go ahead and put our meat and stuff in there. Alrighty, so there's a little bit of water, which is good because remember we're putting this in the oven, so it's gonna keep drying it out a little bit. It smells really good. I'll tell you that. Alright, so we put that in the sink.
Squishy.
Alright, so you're just gonna flatten it out like a little lasagna. And then we're gonna put the potatoes right on top of here. So let's get to that. And we'll let this kind of cool down over here. Alright, y'all, so our potatoes are here.
I'm gonna go ahead with my potato masher and just go ahead and mash that up here. I didn't used to have a potato masher. I used to do it with a fork, and let me tell you, potato masher changes lives. I mean, if you don't have one, the fork will do, but oh man, was that a struggle. All right, so that's done. Now, the creamier you make this, the better it's going to be to spread on top of the other thing. So I'm going to add about a tablespoon of sour cream. I'm gonna add a tablespoon. You guys, I'm not adding salt because remember we salted these and this butter is with salt, so I'm not gonna add any salt. A good amount of butter over here. I'll taste it. If it needs salt, I'll put a little bit. How's that? And we're gonna add some Fairlife. Only putting a little bit for right now. Kind of see how the mix goes here. But yeah, if you guys haven't tried sour cream in your potatoes, y'all don't know what you're missing. Like, my stepmom and my stepsister use it. And I used, like, I don't like sour cream. Like, I'm that type of person that I'm like, I don't want no guac, I don't want no sour cream, nothing on my chips or my tacos. But my stepmom and my stepsister showed me the light. In mashed potato is really good, and in cakes. My stepsister used it once for cake. And I'm a baker, and I've never done that, and it was actually really, really good. So there's that. I feel like this is creamy enough. I'm not gonna add anything else to it. I'm just trying to make sure that the butter is all melted here. And then, let's see. It could use a little bit of salt, y'all. So I'm gonna go ahead and add some. Again, I'm adding the sea salt. And I'm actually gonna add some pepper because y'all know spice is life. So. All right, and then that's it. That's that for this. I'm going to show you how it looks once it is on top of the meat. All right, y'all. So this is the finished look, and then I have here some Parmesan cheese that I grated. I'm just gonna throw that on top. The oven is set to 350 degrees, and that's gonna cook for 30 minutes, I want to say. And I just had to prep it because, you know, the Hispanic in me had a bunch of pots in there. Like, when you have a little ass apartment with no cabinets, Hispanic for life, you put your pots in the oven. So let's go ahead and drizzle our parm on here. So excited. I know, and a lot of people like Parmesan cheese, really. On the lasagna. But you know what? You only live once. YOLO. I saw it done like this. And I was like, yes! Cheese! Who doesn't love cheese? Come on. And some of you are probably asking, well, aren't you lactose intolerant? How can you have cheese? I don't know, y'all. There's something about milk that I just can't have, but I can have cheese. So, now that this is ready, it's going in the oven. I'll show you guys how it looks when it's done. Well,
What's up, you guys? So actually I put it in for 30 and I let it go for 50 minutes. You know, just keep an eye on it. It depends on your oven. This one didn't really, like, it really just browned the edges, and I'm fine with that. I don't need, like, really, really brown cheese. I just don't want to overcook it. So I'm going to go ahead and take it out, and I can't wait to show y'all. So let's see. You guys, it's still bubbling. How awesome is this? You guys, it looks good and it smells good. So the cheese is crusted up here. It's just a little darker on the edges. And that's just because the juice of the meat came up toward the end. I can't wait to try it. I'm so excited. Ew, it's so good. All right, sorry. Guys, I'm just excited. Excited. Looks good. I want to burn myself. Let's see how it tastes. Para con la boca. Yep, it's good. It's good. It is an American dish, so kind of different for me because, you know, I'm Hispanic. But it's still really, really good, you guys. So I am excited to share with you guys that this week Saturday, I did have a special request to do congri, and for those of you that don't know what that is, it's essentially rice and beans just cooked together instead of separately. So we're going to do congri with carne guisada. Carne guisada is just these little chunks of meat in, it's kind of like stew, like the meat you use for stew, but it is in a, with like tomato paste and sofrito. It's going to be real, real good. So don't want to miss next Saturday's shenanigans. All right, y'all, so thank you so much for being with me and doing this little experiment. Till next time.